Okay, so I've had a delivery, and I believe it's my iStock, so I've just tore it open and pulling out the pieces. So we have the main stock piece here, which obviously sits in your shoulder, and this I believe is a slot for the dominant hand controller. So me being right-handed, I'm going to stick the right-hand controller in there. And I think there's another piece in here. Yeah, so this little doohickey here, this has a hole where you're going to thread through your strap cords to link the controllers together so that you get a nice tight stock. I'll show you how that goes if I can work it out. So dominant hand, right hand, it's like the cord threads through here. Gotta pull it tight, but that clips in. So now I've got the stock. I can use that like that. You can see this part goes through here. So this is the thread. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this little piece and see if I can show you here. There's a little hole and a line where you can thread that through. So put the big piece in the large hole. Apologies if you can't see very well. And then thread it through like that. Make sure it locks. Then you get your secondary controller. So for me, it's my left hand. Then you do the exact same thing. You thread that through. If there's room, hopefully there's room for two. Got it. Okay, so now pull that nice and tight. Make sure it locks. Hopefully I can get it out afterwards. And now we have that connection. We have it nice and tight. So you can see, stock goes in, rests on your shoulder. I have a nice tight frame that I can work with, but also, and this is what I like about this one, this is why I chose the iStock. It's nice and flexible here, so you can go from tight to loose if I need to pick up a knife, I need to pick up a grenade, if I need to quickly reload. I don't need to take the controllers out of the shells, I just simply relax this cord and then I've got the freedom of movement. So that's what I like about it, that's what sold me to order one. I'll leave a link in the description where you can find yours if you want to give it a try, and I'll attach some gameplay. Let's see how it goes. Thank you. So here I am using the gun stock, iStock gun stock, and I'm using it in an app called Contractors. So let's pick up our gun. Certainly feels more stable. Let's head over to the target practice and see what I mean about I've still got the flexibility here. I can quickly reload my gun and set it back. So if I want to throw a grenade, pull the pin. That's throwing it with your dominant hand. And there you go, you've still got a good range of movement. It'll take some getting used to for me working with any stock, but I think this one, being as short as it is, it's long enough as you need. But and you've got your flexibility there, you've got full hand movements, but it is something new for me to adjust to. Let's play a game.
That knife would have killed him. You would have poked him once. Got me a whole leg. Oh my god, damn, behind you. Great.
Sara, I've traveled many
got him, traitors. Yes. So there you go. There was some gameplay with the iStock gun stock controller for the Oculus Quest 2. I'll leave a link in the description where you can get yours if you want. It did take a couple of minutes to get used to. I've not used a stock before, but as you can see there, it really did improve the stability of my longer range shots. So I got some pretty good long range kills there that perhaps I wouldn't have last time, or perhaps I would have had to switch to single fire. But I was a lot more confident in the long range shots, so I think this is going to be a big help. And hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.